Soon, this news reached Kansa. He doubted that this might be Devaki's eighth son, and he immediately thought of a plan.
I will arrange a wrestling tournament in which my best wrestlers will compete with Krishna and Balram and kill them. But before they can meet my wrestlers, they will have to meet my mighty elephant, Kuvalya Pida, who has the power of thousands of elephants. If Krishna comes in front of him, he will crush him like anything.
Thinking of this, he called a crew and told him to personally visit Krishna and Balram and invite them for a wrestling tournament. As per the instructions, a crew visited Krishna's house and invited him along with Balram for the wrestling tournament, which Krishna readily accepted. And the day came when Krishna arrived for the wrestling tournament in Mathura. Kansa was informed of Krishna's arrival.
Krishna, welcome to Mathura.
After visiting several places in Mathura, Krishna and Balram arrived at the sacrificial hall. There, Kansa had kept a bow for Dhanuryagya, which was protected by his guards.
This bow is beautiful, but is it a strong one?
For this, we have to look at it very closely.
Let's see it.
Krishna and Balram were amused by the bow and they wanted to test its strength. But with a small pull from Krishna, the bow broke into two pieces with a loud noise.
It seems that my bow kept for Dhanuryagya has been broken. But who could have done this?
He was shocked to see two young boys harassing his guards after breaking his mighty bow. This sight made Kansa horrified. Soon the two boys disappeared.
This Krishna has made my life hell, and I cannot even get my sleep. One more day, and I will get rid of him tomorrow in the wrestling arena. You are finished, Krishna. You are finished, Krishna! My wrestlers are ready to crush you, Krishna. Come soon, Krishna. Death is waiting for you.
Oh, caretaker, move out of our way and let us enter the gate. I'm warning you for the last time, and if you continue to block our way, then I promise you that you and your elephant will meet Yamraj in no time.
It seems my mighty elephant Kuvalya Pida has done his work.
Kans, I am here to take up the challenge of your wrestlers.
Krishna, you don't know that you have walked into the jaws of death. And no one is going to save you and Balram from my wrestlers Chanura and Mustaki.
The young boys took the challenge confidently. Krishna and Balram were excited to finish off the evil-spirited demons and their king. The fight began. It was terrible at first, but soon Krishna and Balram took the lead. Mustaki and Chanura got enough blows from the young boys. Adding to the worry of Kans, soon the two demons fell down. Kans sent more wrestlers to defeat the boys, but all in vain. No one could withstand the mighty blows from the smart boys. Impatiently, Kans got up in anger.
Stop! Stop this! Kill both of them!
He ordered all his soldiers to finish off the boys at once. But Balram blocked all the soldiers alone. Krishna reached Kans and attacked him. His blows made Kans tired. Unable to bear the deadly fight with Krishna, Kans fell down. His end came soon, as he viewed the true form of Mahavishnu. This was how Kans met his end. From the day he heard that he would be killed by Devaki's eighth child, he was cruel to his near and dear ones, and also to humankind. Thus, he was killed by Lord Krishna himself to let this world get rid of the demons. With Kans's killing, began the fall of the demons, and Krishna released many noble kings from their clutches. But Lord Krishna was to play a much bigger role than this, the role which was the most important in the battle of Mahabharata.